Hello everyone, Christophe here. Today I will give you a quick tour about the Waves Explorer. Okay, so the Waves Explorer is a very important tool, whether you are a trader or a developer. It will allow you to check information about a transaction, a Waves address, a token ID, and so on. Okay, so for that you will go to wavesexplorer.com. See, so this is the web application Waves Explorer. So first of all, you will see that on the left, you can switch here in the different network. Okay, so you have mainnet, testnet, stagenet. So basically, we will have a video with more detail about it. But in short, the mainnet is the current network with the real Waves token. Okay, the testnet is the exact same network, but using fictive token, okay, that have no value. It's more for developer testing, okay? And the stagenet is like a network ahead of the two other with the new feature that will eventually be implemented later in the mainnet and testnet, okay? So stagenet is where we test new feature, okay? Okay, so from here, you can see when you arrive on this page, you have a search bar. You can search by address, transaction ID, block signature, alias, okay? You have the list of the latest mainnet block, okay? You see the current block is 217.04.72, okay, with 82 transactions in it. And here's the signature of the miner that generated this block, okay? On the right, you have the list of the unconfirmed transaction. On the top, you can see the current block also, okay? That's what we call the 8 of the blockchain, okay? On the left, you have option to click on block. You will have similar thing with all the list of the block, and you can click on a block and get the detail of the block, okay? Can see the detail here with all the transactions that are included in this block. And these transactions are grouped by the type of transaction. Here it's a transfer, there is 25. If you scroll down, you will see that there is also an exchange transaction, 69, and so on. Okay. You have the peer here. This is all the current node connected to the network, to the mainnet network. Okay. Node, if you click on node, it simply gives you the main node of the Explorer that the Explorer is using. Okay, okay. Back to general information. Generally, especially if you are a trader, not a developer, most of the time when you arrive on Waves Explorer, all that matters to you is the search bar, and you will enter the either a Wave address or transaction ID of what you want to look for. Okay, so let's give it a try. First of all, we will try the address. So let's get a random address. I will click on a block here. Then from here, I will scroll down and I will click on the first transaction and get a random address here, okay? So let's say I arrive on Waves Explorer, I put my address on the top bar, and this will give me all the information about this address, okay? So it's public, anyone can check about any other one address, okay? So you can see the list of the transaction. Here it's mostly transfer, mass transfer, exchange, okay, asset burn, and they are easily identifiable with the colored title here, okay? So you have several tabs on the top. You can click on alias and see the list of alias associated to this account. This one have no alias. You can get the list here of all the assets that are actually on this account. Okay, you can see them here. You have the list same for the non-fungible token. This account have no non-fungible token. Data and script is more for developer. Is if your account have some data written on the data storage, or if it have a script attached to this account. Okay, so this one have no data and probably no script attached. Okay, okay. Back to the transaction. On the top, you can see that you have different information. The first one, regular balance, is all your waves. Okay, then the generating balance is the minimum value of the effective balance during the last 1,000 block. It's a bit advanced, but just so you know, okay? Available balance is your waves minus the waves you list to another node, okay? And finally, the effective balance is your waves plus the waves that someone lists to your node, minus the waves that you list to another node, okay? So you don't necessarily need to know all this stuff, but if you have a node, it's good to understand this, okay? Okay, after that, you can also search by a transaction ID. So you can see here all the transaction, the blue link is the transaction ID. I take a transaction ID here. If I put it in the search bar on the top, I will have the detail of the transaction, okay? So that's it. That's the detail of your transaction here. Okay, you can see the transaction ID here. It's the same. It's in the URL bar on the top. Okay, the type of transaction here is an asset transfer. The timestamp, in which block this transaction have been included. The proof is the signature of the mining node. The transaction that the account have signed with his private key. Okay. The recipient that will receive the transfer. The amount that was transferred is the stacking. Okay. And the fee that you pay in waves. Okay. Eventually an attachment that display information. And the sender address is the one that will receive that is sending this token. Okay. Sender public key is also the public key that's associated to this address of the sender. Okay. If you are a developer, you can have the detail also in JSON. Okay. JSON format. Okay. Go back. So same, you can also search by token ID. Okay. So let's say I will get, here there was an asset burn. So if I click here, I will get here. Okay, see this this token. I click on it, and here the transaction that was used to create the token is also the token ID. Okay, so if I was just using the token ID on the search bar on the top, I will get the same information, the information about the token. Okay, see all the information. So here you have the type. It was an issue, asset issue, because it's the creation of the token. Okay, the timestamp, the block, at what block we have created this token. Same, the proof is the account that signed this block, okay, to create the token, the quantity that have been created, the decimal, okay, the description of the token, if it's reissuable, meaning if we can edit more token or not, okay, the fee you pay, the account paid to create this token, the address and the public key of the sender, and the JSON format, okay. And that's it. That's it for the Web Explorer. Basically, if you are a trader, or mostly what you will do is check your account or check an account in general, check a transaction ID or a token ID using the search bar. That's it. Thank you for watching, and see you next time for more video. Bye-bye.